Hi, Judy. This is Reyne Rice. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you, Reyne?
Great.
Good. I will put you through to Brent right now.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Happy Monday, KMA Land. Time now for the Morning Routine Show. I'm Brent Barnett. A lot of guests lined up for the program today on this 24th day of February. Dr. Margaret Brady will be in about 8:40 with Healthy Tales Retreat in Shenandoah. Stephanie Peterson will be with us around 8:45 with IHOP, as tomorrow is National Pancake Day. We'll learn about that celebration. In the 9 o'clock hour, we'll talk with Andy Ray from United Group Insurance. Our sports features with the Underwood Wrestling Team. It's a leap day kickoff week, as Jean Devin will talk about Saturday being leap day. She'll be here around 9:20 in the studio. And then we'll have another Iowa Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 2020 inductee on the show at around 9:40. We'll be talking with Kirk Skinny Webb at 9:40. Looking forward to that. He'll join us over the phone live. As we start the program today, we're talking with trends expert Reyne Rice, who's given us a roundup from the New York Toy Fair that's taking place. Good morning. How are you today?
Good morning. Hey, it's great to be a part of your show. Thanks for inviting me.
Absolutely. Thanks for being here. You might tell us more about you and your background as we get started.
Okay, well, I'm a global trend hunter. I've been in the toy industry for over three decades. I've worked at Mattel and in the toy industry. So I'm going to all the trade shows around the world, learning about all the hot new items that are going to be out this year and for the holiday season. And right now, I'm coming live from the New York Toy Fair.
That's great. Before we get really into gear here with the New York Toy Fair, I understand maybe you just returned from international?
Yes, I was just at the Toy Fair, the biggest toy fair in the whole world in Nuremberg, Germany. It's about the size of 43 football fields. It's huge.
That's great. Well, tell us what's been going on so far. What are some of the things you expect to see at the New York Toy Fair? And maybe just kind of why they hold it here this early in the year?
Oh, well, they hold it now because they have to get the retailers to buy into the product, and they got the manufacturers to build it, ship it, get it to the stores so the consumers can find the product and purchase it for their families and the kids and themselves.
Very good. What are some of the things you're expecting to see this year?
Well, classic play and pop culture are very popular trends. So we've got a combination here that's inspired by the movie Minions, The Rise of Gru. So kids who love the Minions will go wild for the new Lego building sets with Minions. So they can build brick versions of Kevin and Stewart, who are the two of the main characters in the show. And they're about 6 inches tall and 8 inches tall. And then they turn the models around, and inside, they open them up, and inside there's a little room playset. So there's little tiny accessories like tools and hats and weapons. There's the little Lego minifigures that everyone loves. And the kids can build two different Minion models at a time. And then they can also take Kevin and deconstruct him and rebuild him into Bob, who's one of the third main character, and he practices Kung Fu. And inside the rooms, the kids can enjoy all of the intricate details that Lego is known for. And they match each different Minion's unique personality. Like, kids can create inventions in the lab with Kevin, or they can watch Stuart take a nap in his bedroom. Just fun role play for kids with some of their favorite characters.
That's great. Any other classic toys making a comeback?
Yeah, nostalgia, intergenerational play is popular. People want to play with the toys that they played in their childhood and introduce it to their kids. So Pac-Man is introducing his 40th anniversary this year. So there's a Pac-Man Tamagotchi. And you can raise and nurture your little Tamagotchi characters on your device with the help of Pac-Man, who will save them from the ghosts and the bugs that were in the video game. So for more fun, you can play mini games on your device called Pack Game or Catch Game. You can choose two different device shells, as yellow and black, or you can get a deluxe shell that comes with a Pac-Man case that protects your toy. And of course, they're small enough to fit in your pocket or your bag, and they even have a wearable keychain, so kids can take it wherever they go.
Seems like every year there's always new toys that come out that try to teach kids about the planet. Anything along those lines this year?
Yes, sustainability is a big trend, and there's a company called Aventera Games. They're an award-winning family-owned company that was based in Switzerland, but they brought their toys to the United States now. So they make board games, the ones where you sit on the table, you put them on the table, and people sit around and play together. Now, these games actually help kids learn to conserve natural resources and save the planet. There's one that's called Global Warning, and it encourages players to work together to clean up the world by solving climate change challenges. And they give them solution cards to help, you know, inspire them to find ways to do that. And while they're playing the games, really the players are intuitively learning new behaviors that will reduce their own carbon footprint. And when the behaviors become lifetime habits, of course the players will become global citizens of our planet.
What about some other educational type toys? Anything STEM related for science, technology, engineering, and math?
Yes, actually we have a globe. It's called Orboot from a company called Play Shifu. It's a great STEM toy for kids. They have over 400 highlights and 1,000 cool facts to explore. So it's a talking globe. There's a tap of a finger. Kids can explore and learn with the best interactive globe that's out there right now. They have an Orboot AR app. You download it on your device, either your phone or a tablet. And kids use the touchscreen device, and they just tap on it, and they can learn about visual storytelling, music, voice interactions. They just hover it over the globe over a particular country. They'll learn about wildlife, the type of food people eat there, the culture, the monuments. And it tells them about all these different things that they can explore. It's also available in 8 languages. There's quizzes and challenges in the app, so it teaches kids to learn in a very curious, inquisitive way. And this year, there's actually going to be 2 more planets they're coming out with. One is called World of Dinosaurs, so it's a globe where kids can dive into the prehistoric world. They can learn where these 50 or more dinosaurs lived. They can compare shapes and sizes, and it's really fun. It's a beautiful game. And then the other globe is called A Planet Mars. So you can learn to know about space missions and see the rovers that were traversing Mars and learn all about that. So really fun ways for kids to learn in a spatial kind of 3D way.
Yeah, that's great. We have a little time left, Reyne. Do you mind sharing some of your takeaways from the International Toy Fair in Germany?
Yeah, these same trends are all around the world. I'm a member of a global trend committee, which has people from around the world all consulting in together to pick the top trends. Teaching kids about diversity and inclusion, helping kids understand that there's differences in cultures and religion and ability levels. Like Uno has a game, a Uno Braille game now by Mattel. So there's different ways that kids are learning how to be kind, not only to the environment, but kind to the people around them and who they live with in their world and in their communities.
Yeah, you bet. How can people get more information today on everything you presented here?
They can learn about this all year round and right now about these particular toys by going to dailylounge.com.
Dailylounge.com. Very good. Hey, Reyne, have a good one. Thanks for being with us on the program today.
Okay. Thank you very much, Brent.
Absolutely. Toy and games reporter, tech trends expert, Reyne Rice on the morning routine. It's 828 at the studios. Opening markets coming up next.